Hello, y'all. First time on YouTube making a video. I've seen a lot of YouTube videos of guys with their truck campers and camping out and things. And I thought that'd be a pretty good idea if I converted my camper shell into a little camper setup. So I did. So far, I really like it a whole lot. I put it together last summer. Started last spring. Yeah, my younger years, I used to love to hunt and fish. I still do. But I'm 76 now, and there's things I can't do. Main reason is I had a stroke about 4 or 5 years ago. Kind of messed me up a little bit. So I can't go pheasant hunting anymore. At least walk the field. I can still go out and watch the other hunters and camp out and enjoy myself, which I've done a few times. I just thought I'd like to make a little video of my camper setup and show you how I did it. A lot of the things I did on the video I got from you guys on YouTube. It's a good idea. So you guys just have to pardon me on some of my mistakes I make. That's okay. I'm a beginner. But I want to let you know there's a couple of guys on YouTube that's got camping truck videos, which I really, really enjoy. And one of them is, I think his name is Maverick. And I think he goes by Mav on YouTube. And Mav, if you ever see this video, I'd sure like to meet you someday. I'm sure impressed at how you can put a meal together. I am absolutely amazed. I never was a cook anyway, so that may have something to do with it. But I'm really impressed with your videos. I really love them. And there's another one. His name is Crazy Caddy. That guy's good too. He really presents himself well. Really enjoy his videos very much. But anyway, I just thought I'd give it a try and see what happens. But all right, so much for the gab. Let's take a little tour of my camper and see if we can get through this. Okay. All right. This is my camper. Well, I got it set up. I got me a little TV up there. It's a cheap one. It's a $100 smart TV, probably a little bit over. But let me show that to you. It's something I really enjoy. I like to watch Chiefs play football. Let me show you how this thing works. If I can scoot up here, what you do is you just push it up on the back side and then pull down on it. Hey, it come on. How about that?
I think we're kind of
let's turn that thing off.
And 50 degrees overall, so that's why I'm at 47 here. But the front has come through.
It's
going to turn colder and
there we go. We got that turned off. But anyway, I really like the TV. You know, a lot of things I can't do now outside. So, when I get tired and need a nap or something, I just come in the camper, take a nap, or watch a little TV if I can get a channel on it. Can't always get a channel up where I go, North Central Kansas. But anyway, I made some curtains. They work real good. They slide back and forth. I made it out of, I think it's half inch conduit. And made some hangers here. Let me see if I can show you one of them. Nah, I don't know about this. Yeah, I can't show you. There's a little clamp there. But you guys get the idea there, I think, how the, that holds the conduit in place. And I also got some of this reflective that I use for the windows in the winter time, and it works real good. I don't have them on this window here right now because I like to look out. It's not real cold outside right now. I also got an indoor-outdoor temperature gauge over. If you notice, it's 41 degrees, almost 42 outside. Shoot, I got it up to 82 now. It's time to turn this heater off. Boy, you talk about a good little heater. That's 110. That's a jim dandy. I really like that thing. I take a generator along with me when I go. And that's what I run all my 110 stuff and charge my battery stuff up on. I also got a jackery that I put right there when I'm camping, right there where my TV speaker is. Also got a real nice Coleman stove. It's got a grill in the inside of it. It works real well. I like to cook outside, but it gets cold. You gotta cook inside. But Mav and Crazy Cat, it don't matter what temperature it is, they're gonna go outside and cook anyway, which is awesome. All right, well, this is my front window. Got a little slide here, open it up. And I'll show you when I get outside, but right up here, I got one of those pipe insulation foam things I put between the cab and the camper. Keep the rain and snow and stuff from blowing in. And my lights up there, that 110 LED lights, I got at Menards, which work real well. I also got over here a single cup coffee maker, which runs off 110, works real good. Over here, I just got some miscellaneous boxes of stuff that I'll take along with me. And down here, this, that brown table, and there's a black one back there. That black one I usually use outside. That brown one, when I'm inside and cooking, I'll just take it down and put it in between here, and put stuff on it. Works real good. Got me a little trash can I use here. It's just a regular little bucket. And I use shopping bags as trash bags. That works real good too. Got me a good fire extinguisher, I hope. Yep, that's still good. Looks like it survived the winter. Well, winter ain't over yet. Down here, I keep my trash bags and a few little off odds and ends. This is my coffee. Keep my coffee in there. And also, on my bed here, I use it's an old Army sleeping bag. It's a down sleeping bag. Boy, it's a good one. I've used it over the years. It's really good. Let me show you something here I bought the other day off Amazon. You can see that right there, that yellow thing, the green light on it. That's a CGMI circuit breaker, or I don't know exactly what it's called, but it's kind of a protection from a 110 that comes in from the electrical source and protects everything in my camper. Now you see, this is my stove. Let's see if I can get my finger in there. that one right there is my stove, my electric heater. And this is a extension cord which runs up front, which works my front lights. And this one here, this works this power strip right here, which works my lights here on the back. Okay. Also, on my TV, I got a indoor-outdoor antenna right there. When I bought it off Amazon, it was rated at 400-mile range. But don't be deceived by that. The max you can get out of any indoor-outdoor antenna is 100 miles. So that's it. It's just what it looks like from where I'm at now. I'm at home. This is what I look outside and see. All right. I think I might take you outside and show you a couple little items that I got put together on the camper. All right. I'm outside now. This is the back of my camper. I've got a step there that I used to get up in and out of the camper. Boy, I couldn't do it without that. I put a string up there for my lid door so it don't slam open or shut. Oh, here I got to just where I carry my propane tank and my water jugs when I'm winter camping, which I don't do a whole lot. I got a little buddy heater back over here. Underneath there, I got a hose that'll run through here through that little hole down there and goes outside, and I keep my propane tank down there. All right, Crazy Cuddy, I want to thank you for this idea. This is my electrical hookup. I'll unplug it here and show it to you. But it works real good. I love this thing. You pull up and you hook your generator in there or whatever. It works real good. I put this foam on there to kind of keep the weather out of it. Rain and what have you. And it seems to work okay. Alright, now this foam you see here, this is what I got up between my cab and my camper. I don't know if you can see it too well or not. Well, you might be able to see it up there, but anyway, it goes between the cab and the camper. And right here is where I keep my outdoor thermometer. Or inside, knowing what the outside temperature is. That works real good. This is my old truck I've had since 2001. It's a 2000 F-350 Ford. And let me give you a shot of here. This is my fifth wheel. And let me walk out here and I'll give you a shot of my truck, the front of it. There's my truck. There's my fifth wheel. It's a 2000 2001. Which one of these you think I like better, my truck camper or my fifth wheel? Well, I tell you, I like my fifth wheel. Whenever you get to where you're going, I love it. But pulling it behind the truck, I don't like it, never did like it. Just too much to worry about for me. So, yep, I converted from that to this, which I really, really enjoy. This gets good gas mileage on it. An F-350, four-wheel drive. Well, folks, I think that's gonna about do it on this.
Let's see if you can see that foam up there. Yeah, you can see it a little bit between the cab. That works real good. Keeps the rain out. There's that reflective I use for my windows. I'm really impressed with that. Well, I think that's going to be about it, y'all, for this video. I'm planning on going out west, I don't know, as soon as it warms up a little bit. And when it warms up, I might take you along. We'll just have to wait and see about that. Don't know. All right, it's about 40 degrees. It's kind of cold out here for me, 76-year-old guy. But anyway, here's my part. I hope you guys like it. If you don't, that's okay too. You ain't gonna hurt this old man's feelings. All right, we'll catch you later. Now I gotta try to edit this. All right, catch y'all on the next one. Bye.